Season of Lent. So let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may begin with holy fasting this campaign of Christian service, so that as we take up battle against spiritual evils, we may be armed with weapons of self-restraint. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. A reading from the prophet Joel. Now it is the Lord who speaks. Come back to me with all your heart, fasting, weeping, mourning. Let your hearts be broken, not your garments torn. Turn to the Lord your God again, for he is all tenderness and compassion, slow to anger, rich in graciousness, and ready to relent. Who knows if he will not turn again, will not relent, will not leave a blessing as he passes. Oblation and libation for the Lord your God. Sound the trumpet in Zion, order a fast, proclaim a solemn assembly. Call the people together, summon the community, assemble the elders, gather the children, even the infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom leave his bedroom and the bride her alcove. Between vestibule and altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, lament. Let them say, spare your people, Lord. Do not make your heritage a thing of shame, a byword for the nations. Why should it be said among the nations, where is their God? Then the Lord, jealous on behalf of his land, took pity on his people. The word of the Lord. The response is, have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned. Have mercy on me, God, in your kindness, in your compassion blot out my offence. O wash me more and more from my guilt, and cleanse me from my sin. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned. My offences, truly I know them, my sin is always before me. Against you alone have I sinned. What is evil in your sight I have done. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned. A pure heart create for me, O God, put a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, nor deprive me of your Holy Spirit. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned. Give me again the joy of your help, with a spirit of fervour sustain me. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. We are ambassadors for Christ. It is as though God were appealing through us, and the appeal that we make in Christ's name is, be reconciled to God. For our sake, God made the sinless one into sin, so that in him we might become the goodness of God. As his fellow workers, we beg you once again not to neglect the grace of God that you have received. For he says, at the favourable time I have listened to you, on the day of salvation I came to your help. Well, now is a favourable time. This is a day of salvation. The word of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. A pure heart create for me, O God, and give me again the joy of your help. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, be careful not to parade your good deeds before men to attract their notice. By doing this you will lose all reward from your Father in heaven. So when you give alms, do not have it trumpeted before you. This is what the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets to win men's admiration. I tell you solemnly, they have had their reward. But when you give alms, your left hand must not know what your right is doing. Your almsgiving must be secret, and your Father who sees all that is done in secret will reward you. And when you pray, do not imitate the hypocrites. They love to say their prayers standing up in the synagogues and in the street corners for people to see them. I tell you solemnly, they have had their reward. But when you pray, go to your private room, and when you've shut your door, pray to your Father who is in that secret place, and your Father who sees all that is done in secret will reward you. When you fast, do not put on a gloomy look as the hypocrites do. They pull long faces to let men know they are fasting. I tell you solemnly, they have had their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that no one will know you're fasting, except your Father who sees all that is done in secret. And your Father who sees all that is done in secret will reward you. The Gospel of the Lord. And so we begin this Lenten season, these weeks of preparing ourselves for the mysteries of Holy Week and for the joy of Easter. As I said at the beginning, this is obviously a very different Ash Wednesday. We don't have ashes to distribute, to put on your foreheads. But we do that. We have ashes put on our foreheads normally as an outward sign of something that we are going to be doing within. Having the ashes on our forehead is a sign to ourselves and to each other and to the rest of society that during these weeks of Lent we are going to do our best through extra prayer and fasting, giving things up or taking up new things and giving to charity, that we're going to use these weeks to try and do these things, so that the ashes are an outward sign of us embarking on this Lenten season. So perhaps this year it gives us a wee chance to focus more on what's going on within us rather than the exterior signs, the external signs of the ashes. Perhaps it's good for us to focus more today on exactly what we're going to be doing for Lent to draw ourselves closer to Christ. In the Gospel passage, we're given three things that we should be trying to do. The first is giving alms. That means giving to charity. Usually in school at this time, there are the wee skiaff boxes and we give a wee bit more to Mary's Meal or Mary's Meals or our favourite charities or whatever. Maybe that's a wee thing for you to consider to do at home. Just having a wee box yourself that you might add some money to once or twice a week. We're also encouraged to pray more. Doesn't mean that we have to be on our knees all day, but nevertheless, if we try and make sure during Lent that first thing in the morning and last thing at night, we just say a wee prayer to Jesus, thanking him for the new day, thanking him for everything he does for us, but thanking him for the cross as well. We are heading towards the cross, we're heading towards Calvary, almost in pilgrimage with Jesus. And so it's important that we up our prayers, that we up our trust and our hope in him through our prayers. And the final thing that the Gospel encourages us to do is to fast. That usually means giving up something. You may have chosen to give up sweets or crisps or iron brew. But fasting can also mean taking up something different that is maybe a wee sacrifice for us. There's no harm in making wee sacrifices during Lent, feeling the pinch just a wee bit, because of course Jesus felt the pinch a big bit on the cross, so there's no harm in us just making wee acts of sacrifice or fasting to help us in this season of Lent. But I'm sorry that we can't get together, boys and girls, for this Ash Wednesday. Hopefully by the end of Lent we will be able to have gathered together again, but I'll be praying for you all every day of Lent, hoping that you make the most of these weeks of preparing for Holy Week and Easter. It means if we put in the effort now of preparing ourselves well, it means that come Easter we can rejoice all the more to know that Jesus is risen from the dead. Let's pray together in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And we'll just seek the guidance and friendship of Mary, the mother of us all. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Let us pray. Pour out a spirit of holiness, O God, on those who bow before your majesty, and by your mercy may they merit the reward you promise to those who do penance. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.